stage or the platform with such distinguished musicians. Mick O'Brien, the grand pure musician of the year. Ultan O'Brien, no relation. Shahab Coohe on the santoor. You may have noticed a slight likeness, Shayan Coohe on the changes as soon as there are people in the space. So when we come in and rehearse in the space, it's always, oh my god, it's so gloomy in here, we can't hear anything. As soon as the audience comes in, it's all good, we're reasonably well. We began with a blend of pieces, which is much like our group. We're a blend of people, and we try and collaborate, we try and integrate the blend of people that we are, and that's really what our mission is about integration and collaboration. First piece we came to play, you may recognize, is Bach, Jesus Joy of Man's Desiring, which is written in 1723, which I looked up yesterday on Google. And then we merged into a piece by Shahab here, which is called The Opening, which is written 300 years later. And we kind of blended them together and mixed and matched them and that sort of thing, which is kind of what we do a little bit in the art of collaboration and with the Tulca. That opening happens to be on our CD, and we just so happen to have some CDs. You think you really should treat yourself to somebody to look after yourselves. Loads of CDs you got to. Other thing I'd love for you to do today is to sign up to our newsletter and our mailing list, and we may actually even put something on it, which could include some articles and some music and what we're doing next. Anything else I need to say? No, I think that's it. I'd like to now continue, and I'd like to invite one of our members of the Art of Collaboration, which is Professor Jim Lucy, to recite a poem for us, a beautiful poem by Seamus Heaney called Limbo, and whose influence is Shahab's work. And Shahab will mention something about his work in a couple of pieces' time.
Well, thank you, Paul. Thank you everybody for being here, and this is a great privilege for me, and I want to thank Paul and all my friends here at Tulca. The idea of coming together meant a great deal to us before, but it certainly meant a great deal during the COVID year. And so it's wonderful to be back here as part of that. And in so many ways, this is about integrating and collaborating talents and interests, enthusiasms, points of view. And so this poem inspired Shahab and our friends to write a piece we're going to hear in a moment. And with your attention, I read Seamus Heaney's poem, Limbo. Fishermen at Ballyshannon netted an infant last night, along with the salmon, an illegitimate spawning, a small one thrown back to the waters. But I'm sure, as she stood in the shallows, ducking him tenderly till the frozen knobs of her wrists were dead as the gravel, he was a minnow with hooks tearing her open. She waded in under the sign of her cross. He was hauled in with the fish. Now limbo will be a cold glitter of souls through some far briny zone. Even Christ pounds, unhealed, smart, and cannot fish there.
thank you so much for being here. It's a pleasure to be back in the Hugh Lane. It's great to be with all these great musicians and colleagues and friends. I think Paul said it all. And I'm just going to introduce the next piece, which is called Always Be. And as you can tell with the name, it's written in B minor. But it's not about the key, it's about always be, means being present and making music now. And unfortunately, the score that I've given to my friends are not clear. So every time we play, it sounds different. And so I think that's the beauty of this piece. And it's the beauty of collaborating and making music, improvising, and living the time, living the present, which is the most important thing. So I hope you live the present and enjoy the peace.
creativity and and technology. So we got together to record this album in a kind of spontaneous way, really, in the organ room at the Royal Irish Academy of Music. And we record this at the Academy, and we're about creativity and overture.
Well, thank you, Paul. So, it's a kind of a magical experience for me. These are fine musicians and really great talents, and I'm wondering what I'm doing in a room in the Academy with them. And they said, well, just go back a little bit, because when they were making this disc, producing it, recording it, writing it, we were going through COVID. I was in my shed in the back garden going through what we were all going through in terms of isolation, contemplating the end of my career, 40 years of working in the medicine of the mind, maybe looking at another, who knows, talking to Paul and hearing the inspiration of these young people in the towns, the O'Briens, the Coohes, and the Rose. And it came to me that this was a metaphor for what I was trying to do, which is write a book about wellness and well-being. There's a concept in wellness and recovery called chime, and it's about making progress through connecting with others, through restoring hope, finding your identity, your meaning, and empowerment. And all of a sudden that resonated with making music. And so they invited me to just witness them making the music. And then, to my surprise, Shahab said, "Why don't you talk now, Jim?" And I said, "What will I say?" And he said, "Just the usual shite you always say." I think that sort of explains it, doesn't it, Paul? Let's just do it. But just to say, I had a hell of a day. Privileged to meet several people. And in the books I've been writing over the years, it's really trying to capture those moments of what people tell me, they teach me in therapy, that I've struggled to do, and it's never the same. I think Stevenson said that. It's never the spoken word is much better. But you try and capture it. And in the atmosphere of the music that my friends were making, we went into a meditation and tried to capture the things that were said that day. And now it's written down, but then it was fresh and made in the moment of the music, in the collaboration, in the chiming, in the whole. So let's do it. Somehow a different person. I think it's because after a lifetime of trying to listen to people, I've learned to hear. It's not the same thing. Somehow interrupting, offering solutions, just got in the way. Life had become a piece of engineering. How could this be? I asked him. I've started hearing, not just listening. It's like the music. Everybody's counting, but it doesn't matter. It's being here that's what matters. Become clearer. Perhaps no more instruction is necessary. Perhaps the problem with the uncertainty is trying to face it, rather than just being in it, collaborating with each other, and knowing together we will live it for better. Thank you.
agat con portella castanish a scream ne hen agus Paul Ro couple blino hin fado agus hugger mar inspira don fila don fair as limnach Michael Hartnett. So we took we wrote a piece together about 10 years ago when I was 5 and Paul was
70.
Paul wasn't. And Michael Hartnett was the poet I was interested in for a while, because when I was 5 I was trying to do this project about outsiders, or some notion about outsiders. And I was thinking it'd be great to just get in touch with a bunch of weirdos or outsiders to get some help in it. So I called Paul and we were kind of sending ideas back and forth, or little snippets of melodies, and there was a bit of an exchange too between like, traditional music and Paul's background in classical and contemporary classical and new music and whatnot. And Aspa Cuddle was the name of a poem from Michael Hartnett that we were working on a bit, and there's a lovely line in it that says, "Ancient bio, so mind alive with sleeping ants," and it's a lot about the light coming in the morning and how annoying that is. And excuse me one second, it's just this has been annoying me. See, I'm doing a lot of yoga and I only eat eggs now, so the waste eggs falling away. But the other thing is, of course, I arrived here in a really nice woolen cardigan that I have to wear, and then they're all wearing fucking suits. Change into this. Anyway, mind alive is this tune.
Thank you. through my daughter and Paul's son, we actually got acquainted. And Paul wanted to, he knew my daughter very well, and he was kind of helping her out, different things with music. And they both, even they met both in the Academy of Music. And so Paul talked to Eva and he decided, I'd really like to learn a few simple tunes and him listen. Now you give this man notes upside down, back to front, and he just played them for you, no problem. But playing a simple Irish tune can be a little bit difficult for a classical musician because they're coming from a completely different side of the world, really. And kind of then I said, yeah, that's interesting, because I'd love to go to someone and just maybe learn a little bit of reading and get a little bit of an idea about that. So we did, we met up. And then it turned out that we were in school together. But I was too busy.
He was in the A class.
I don't know about that.
I never saw him because I was in the D class.
We were both the same year in this institution out there in Artane. You might have heard of it. It's not what you're thinking. No, we weren't orphans. No. But so I was too busy playing hurling and football. And Paul was in the Artane band playing how to read music and be very good. You know, so anyway, we came together. And the first couple of weeks, we were doing diligently working in half an hour with Paul and traditional music, and then I think that flute. He said, no, mate, that's not what's written down. And that, okay, so he said, by the way, we have a little project coming up. And then, of course, all this learning went up, and we just ended up playing with the lads, both in the gym. And this turned out to be a great kind of a collaboration, really, which was great, all kinds of music. And so, and this is where we're coming to. So I think it was Shahab, was that your date? This one that we're playing?
No.
Cheers, Jake. And so we're going to play the Jake. And then we're going to finish up with Follow Me Up the Carol, or something to call it Follow Me Down the Carol, or whatever it is. It's a song as well. So we're going to end up with, so we're going to end somewhere in Carol. And then maybe come back here at some stage. We'll see you on the journey somewhere.
Thank you. Thank you.
So if any of you have any ideas, I'm pointing this, whoa. Okay, put this down. If any of you have any ideas about collaboration or interested in collaborating, we're really interested in interdisciplinary collaboration between music, medicine, science, design, and so business, so we're very open to suggestions and ideas. Please, if email us at one of the longest email addresses, the Art of Collaboration Ireland, the Art of Collaboration Ireland at gmail.com. We'd love to bring it to the widest possible community of people, and we're open to ideas. What got us here won't get us there in this world. We need creativity. And so part of what we're about here is that exploration of the unknown, living in this VUCA world, volatile, uncertain, complex, and ambiguous. So, yeah, if you have ideas, it's almost a kind of a political aspect to this, with a small p in terms of this whole endeavor. So we're very glad to hear any suggestions and ideas you might have. Please come and talk to any musicians and so forth, and other people. Drop us a line. Anything else to say? Yeah, we're all collaborative at heart, and you simply need to create opportunities to listen. Quoting from Jim's words, we need to listen. There's a reason we have two of these and one of these. So, listen. Oh, better say the name of June's. So we have Bridget Flynn rolling on the barrel and the morning dew. Thank you all.
Thank you.